You were born in Latvia in 1980 during the Soviet era.
How do you know all these things about me? That's classified information.
It's on Wikipedia.
Wikipedia. No, yes, that's true.
What was it like for you growing up? Tell me about your experience there.
It's like I have kind of an unusual combination of things. I grew up, yes, I was born in Latvia, in Riga, the capital city of Latvia, which was a republic of the Soviet Union, and now it's a country of its own, which it used to be originally, then became, you know, the conglomerate that was the Soviet Union, and then became its own country again. And during the Soviet Union era is when I was born there, but I am not Latvian. My mom is Russian. My dad is Armenian. And Armenia was also a republic of the Soviet Union and is also a country now. And so, yeah, like I lived in a place, it's sort of like when British people were born and grew up in Hong Kong. Like I didn't have anything to do culturally with Latvia.
Some more Russian culture?
Yeah, like Russian. I spoke Russian to my parents.
You speak Russian still?
I do. Probably not as good as I... you know, to a Russian speaker as I should, but I can get by.
Interesting.
And I still speak to my family in Russian. So, and then like I would go sometimes. My parents were circus performers and they traveled all over the country. Did I mention
that? Is that real?
Yeah. No,
that's
for real.
That's amazing. That's the trope from like novels.
I guess. Yeah. I mean, it's very exotic upbringing. But I would travel with them. They traveled like around the country. But the USSR is like the entire. Russia is pretty big now. What is Russia? It's like bigger than Pluto surface area or something. But it was huger then because of all the republics were included in it. So it was this monster of a country. And they toured everywhere because in Russia at the time, maybe still. Circus is a little more like a high class kind of entertainment. It's like regular circus in the Soviet Union was like Cirque du Soleil here. Like it was like this thing. Every major city had a circus building, like a proper little built building for it. And they would, my parents would tour with different companies and I'd go with them. And when I went to school, I'd stay in Riga, go to school, the normal school year with my grandmother. I would just live, you know, in one place. But then in summer breaks, I would still tour with my parents. So
that's crazy.
A kid. It was a weird...
You enjoyed going on tour with them?
Yeah. I mean, I look forward to it. It was fun, you know. There's other... You feel like this exclusive club because there's other circus kids of other performers. And you get to, like, run backstage and hang out. And all the local townies are, like, these, like, lame children. And we can run away from them to the behind-the-scenes part of the circus. And
so your parents are extreme athletes?
Well, no, the act that they did, my dad was a circus performer from young age, and he was first an acrobat. Yeah, he was in an acrobatic troupe. Then he became a juggler and like a clown kind of sort of comedy character guy. And he was in partnership with this other famous kind of comedian mime guy from the Soviet Union. And then he went out on his own. And then eventually my mom, who was just a medical school student. She in Latvia. He performed. He toured in Latvia. Wow. She ran away with him.
Dude, your dad is killing it. Yeah, your mom literally ran off and joined the circus.
Yeah,
it's unbelievable.
Against her family's wishes. And she quit medical school, not just ran.
That's like the biggest betrayal
for a parent.
Yeah, for a parent, she quit
medical school.
So wow. That is pretty insane.
And together they had like a hula hoop act. I don't know if you've ever seen this kind of thing where a woman will do like a bunch of hula hoops and do crazy like things with it. And they had sort of a duo kind of act where they would be these like cowboys, like this cowboy duo and do like it's sort of half comedy, half sort of this skill juggling demonstration.
That I did not expect that background for you. I'm still not sure if you just made all that up.
A captain decision. No, honestly, that's completely
real. That is amazing. So how
did you end up?
How did you come to be here?
Well, like a lot of people from that time, from that era, from that place, it wasn't that fun. Like there were a lot of problems. Like me as a child, I actually don't have like scary negative memories of the Soviet Union. It was like this little, not little, but like this isolated sort of thing where you don't know. You have an inkling of how the outside world is.
It's a bubble.
And you have a. You have a clear inkling that it's cooler and better. Like outside of the country is Disney World. And here it's a little bit like the soap only looks one way and everything you buy is one kind of thing. Huh. It's a little bit gray. And
I find that interesting. Even people living in the USSR at the time knew that it was better outside. Oh, yeah. Because there's that powerful propaganda to make that rest of the world seem scary and bad.
Yeah, I think when I was growing up in the 80s, that was when it was like the veil was falling away, even though the Iron Curtain is still up. Yeah.
Yeah.
And people knew it's better. Like people, especially among performers, that's one of the only kind of groups that would be able to go outside the country, or like athletes and stuff.
Right.
You know, they go with like a little KGB agent in tow and go.
So there was agents with you guys when you traveled?
No. Well, like I said, during my time growing up, they never went abroad. But like before I was born, my dad, traveled all over the world and stuff on his own. And they would have like an agent responsible for the troop. And,
so what was your dad's perspective on the USSR, having been outside the country and everything?
He was always kind of like a wry, kind of like rebel, but not like he wouldn't, you know,
not
mess with
brazen.
Anything. Yeah, he would just be like, I don't... There's every place, even the circuses, the backstages of circuses, it had like a red corner, they called it, a red room or whatever. Maybe my red room is based on that. I haven't thought.
What? No, but
where it would be like where the Communist Party, because everyone in the country is part of the Communist Party, it would have little meetings like related to party patriotic things, and he would never go to those things, and it's like he didn't take it seriously.
I just read 1984 for the first time. It's incredible the parallels. I mean, it was clearly based on Communist Russia, I think, the book.
That makes sense.
But hearing you talk about it really conjures the visions of it.
Yeah. And it's strange because I understand that stuff now, but as a kid, like, I didn't feel the ominousness of it. I just thought, like, this is where we are and the world is cooler. Like, it would be nice to go to America one day. And a lot of people thought that way, and they concocted plots to do it. Like, my parents did the old, like, that movie, what's it called? Something on the Hudson with Robin Williams, where he plays, like, a Russian guy that defects. Mm. And so they did a thing where they got into a situation where they could go on tour in America, and then they just asked for political asylum. And
Moscow on the Hudson.
Moscow on the Hudson, yeah. So they did it a little bit risky because they had me, and they left. They decided the safest way to do this is leave me behind.
Oh, my God.
Yeah, and then go. Shit. They had some friends, like another performer pair that did this earlier in the early 80s. They had this contact out here, and they helped him arrange that stuff. And then they went, and they knew that they'd be gone for 2 years, having left me behind. And they would get asylum, they would get proper status, and then they would, hopefully, the way the rules worked, they knew that they would allow them to have their child.
Eventually.
But they kind of banked on this working, and they did.
So did you know what they were up to?
I mean, I understood. I was like 11. I came here at 12 years old. So like 2 years prior to that, I guess I was 10. And I understood it, but I was too little to be too freaked out about it, I guess. I was like, this is the plan. Yeah, I guess I'll just wait. And then for 2 years, I was with my parents. Yeah.
Wow.
And then eventually the call came. And I was kind of like, I also had no reservations. I was sure, like, my mom and dad are getting me. I'm going to America. So everybody in my, like, school and everybody, I was like, you guys enjoy this while it lasts, because it's going to be gone. And then, you know, it could have not happened.
Oh, yeah.
It could have been horrible, but
incredible.
Luckily, it worked out.